Please take your seats quickly, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Hi, guys, and welcome to OneMinuteTennis.com. In today's session, I want to talk to you about the swing path on the forehand, and I want to show you a simple and precise and accurate way for you to always have the perfect swing path every single time that you play. You'll be able to add power and spin, and you'll create a wonderful paradox. The wonderful paradox is that the faster you swing at the ball, the more the ball will go in. Now, when you watch truly high-level players or professional players hitting or playing, then on the forehand side, they swing at almost maximum speed. The reason that they do this is that the faster they swing, the more spin they create. They're actually creating more spin than forward momentum, and so the ball actually becomes safer. To do this, you have to have a movement known as pronation, right in the heart of the stroke. And pronation's pretty simple. It's where we turn the limb inwards. So if I turn my hand inwards like this, then I've pronated my hand. If I turn my feet in like this, then I've pronated my feet. This is supination. This is pronation. But to do this at exactly the right time, we need to have a truly perfect swing path. And if that's not natural for you and you don't do this from an early age, it can be quite challenging. But a great way to get the feeling of this and to be able to correct it right in the heart of a game is to think of fingers and thumbs. Let me show you what I mean. So first I'm going to show you with the tennis racket, and then I'm going to show you without the tennis racket. And I strongly suggest that you actually shadow this and get the feel of it without the racket, and then add the racket as a separate entity. So first let's look at the stroke without pronation. And I make the stroke and I have this classic finish here. And my hand has not turned inwards. My hand has stayed neutral. Now I'm going to change this and I'm going to make pronation. And now my hand has turned distinctly inwards, without the turn and with the turn. Now this is not a movement from the wrist or the elbow. The movement actually begins from my shoulder as I rotate the whole arm inward. If I do it with my wrist, then I'll create spin but very little speed. But when I do it with the whole arm, I create this wonderful blend of power and spin. And to find this, to understand it and be able to reproduce it every time, let's look at the relationship between the fingers and the thumbs. So I'm now going to reproduce the movement of the classic forehand without pronation, without my racket. And I take the racket back and I bring the hands together and the fingers come to the fingers and the thumb comes to the thumb. But now I'm going to reproduce the stroke, or with an imaginary racket again, without the racket, and I'm going to add pronation. And this time, what happens at the end is that the thumb goes to the finger and the finger goes to the thumb. If we haven't looked at that closely, without pronation, finger to finger, thumb to thumb. With pronation, thumb to finger, and finger to thumb. When you've got the feeling of this, then the next thing to do is to add the racket and to alternate between the finger to finger, thumb to thumb ending, non-pronation, and the finger to thumb, thumb to finger, ending with pronation. And although you don't need to swing any faster, you'll immediately hear the difference in the racket speed as it's dramatically increased when we add pronation. So the classic forehand, finger to finger, thumb to thumb, and now the pronated forehand, finger to thumb, thumb to finger. Classic and pronated. As you add pronation, then you get this tremendous increase in racket speed, but the whole swing path has changed, and you're now making a stroke that is very likely to create heavy topspin as well as racket speed and power on the ball. And now the last progression is to hit balls, but ensuring that your thumb is meeting your finger at the end of every stroke. It's a great feeling to be able to swing faster and more aggressively on the big points. So find finger to thumb and find thumb to finger. Play around with it without the racket. It's much easier to find without the racket than it is with. And then reproduce it with the racket. And you'll find that you have way more control on the forehand. And you have this great feeling that on the big point, on the really important point, you don't slow down, you don't push. You swing faster, you swing harder and more aggressively. If you like my ideas on tennis, check out what we're doing offline. I'm helping players in over 40 countries all over the world with a unique blend of video analysis and one-to-one personalized training. And check out our books on Amazon. We have books on every aspect of the game, and the books are broken down into very detailed explanations of the science of the strokes, and then super simple solutions that are clearly illustrated. Everything we do is geared to help you become the best tennis player you can be. So, Don't go finger to finger, don't go thumb to thumb. Find finger to thumb and thumb to finger, and you'll add more power, more speed, more spin, and you'll play better tennis today. Thanks for watching and see you next time for more unique tennis lessons that really work.